day and the life and the word to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming and glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth and sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Our hearts still cling to this body, for we cannot disassociate it from the beloved one who dwells in it and animated it. But it is really only the worn-out garment that Mr. Brown has cast aside. Thus far, we still reverence it because of the tender memories that gather about it. We now consign it to its original element, looking with confidence to the fashioning of that perfect body that is in Christ Jesus. Gracious Heavenly Father, we believe that you watch over your creation wisely and lovingly, caring for all things from the greatest to the least, that not even a sparrow that falls to the ground escapes your notice and care. We now leave Mr. Brown's body in your keeping, praying and believing that you would do what is best for it, for us, and for all things. As we go from this place, may your blessings go with us. And may your grace, mercy, and peace be multiplied to us forevermore in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
If I can please ask for everybody to join me in the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, as we forgive our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Temptation. Forever.
Everyone has a rose in their hand. You can place it on Mr. Brown's casket as a symbol of your love and loyalty for him, or you can choose to take it home as a memory. If I can ask for his children to step forward.
So this is gonna this